Welcome back. Let's take this opportunity to go through the games that we played yesterday. I believe these are sorted in reverse chronological order. I'm not entirely sure how best to navigate these in a list form, but we gotta start somewhere, right? So I think I can't click the result to open the game. I have to click the game score. So we'll click this game score and take a look. So you'll note this is a similar perspective to what I had yesterday. However, as we examine games, now I'm actually curious, when I navigate this list, okay, the leftmost is the oldest game. That makes sense. See, as I analyze games, I'll have the analyzer over here. There are tools I can install. My computer to help with the analysis. Yeah, he did wish me good luck before this game. I think in the tournament chat I had wished him the same. I had my screen in full screen mode, so I was able to see the board nice and large. I did not see the chat over here during the game, unfortunately. So yeah, our opponent was Scrabble Master Evans Clinchy, the tournament organizer. Very, very strong player. This would be equivalent to you going to a chess tournament and facing a master. So thankfully with Scrabble, there is some variance in just based on your drawing tiles randomly. It's possible for you to get a combination that can make the game interesting. Whereas in chess, everybody starts with exactly the same thing. Usually they don't play like chess 960 or some other randomized thing. So one thing I found is once the tiles are on the board, that really the point values that are on the tiles really don't guide very much where I choose to play. I mean, I know, like, I think a P is a 3 or a 4, a D is a 2, the vowels are 1 apiece, and I think the Y is a 3. Even if I'm off by 1 or 2, having all the little point markers on the tiles was distracting me a ton, so I wrote a user style to hide all the point markers. Yeah, hello. So, oh goodness, since we played this game yesterday, I wonder how many of my own plays I'm going to remember. Odds are not very good. I could tell you like the sorts of things that I was considering. So I can see down here I have fig under this. I have vox if I want to dump my v and x. Also fox. Oh, that's interesting. I don't think I considered fox yesterday. And I have XI, and then I could play across. I think I did XI up here. Chi or she. That got rid of one of my duplicated I's and the X. I think that was a reasonable play, but perhaps there's better. Fixive. So that dumps the F and the V and both I's. Yeah, during the game, FY did occur to me, but this is beautiful. Suffixive is best by far because it leaves a much better. You're stuck with the G at the end, but that's okay. You've played an F and a V and an X, which are all challenging to play. Yeah, fix improves over my play. Fixive, fix. So. There's all various ways you could play fixive and fix. Five down here. I was going to start looking for plays involving my E, but figured I really needed to get the X played. So on equity, this is not as good as fix. It would have been better to play fix or definitely fix if I knew it were a word. But yeah, the analyzer recommends fix either here with phi or here with if and d. Wish I'd thought of this. This is definitely something I could have found, and I would have give left over, which is a really nice, comparatively a nice rack. All right, and here I think I just played something that allowed me to score the cue. Oh, I played Vi, which I still think is reasonable. Is there better? Ego. What is this? Obviously, studying fours involving a heavy tile, like an F, could be useful. Oh, fixive again. That's amusing. Fig down here. So duplicating the E is not as bad as, in fact, it has to. This analyzer prefers this leaf over GOVE. Duplicating the E, I guess, is something I should not have been too concerned about. So fig and vig. Vi is on here. It just. Oh, I'm sorry. I don't have a V in the E. I have an F and an E. Yeah, okay. I could see why EEOV is better or more enjoyable than EFGO. Although, actually, no, this is the score here, and then this is the equity of the play. So these two leaves are about equal here. It's just the score's 2 more points. And some people would have opinions about the G. So, depends on your preference where you want to deduplicate the E, because there are a lot of E's. And okay, I can occasionally complain that, okay, he got 2 blanks, how fair is that? That sort of thing. But, you know, that happens. So we just move beyond it. So flood, I dumped both my O's and the F. Yes, so C does not work well in parallel plays. I did spend some time trying to find parallel plays with the C, which is just silly. There's no parallel play other than CH that supports a C. And I don't see a way to, like, I can't fit any G word here, can I? Oh, I don't even have to look at all these double word scores over here. This score is decently on its own because there is a double word score right there. And this does serve a similar purpose of dumping high scoring tiles and the O pair. This blocks bingos, except through the O, where there could be a double-double. There's no reason to expect the opponent to have any particular hand here. But, oh, all right, Fogey. Yeah, that's playable. Wait, why is Goofy so much higher than Fogey? It's just because it scores 2 more points. These are all pretty similar. Golfer, I would not do. Yeah, Fogey burning the E's, not so smart. Or go. That's interesting. A bit risky, but yeah, so. Yeah, fog, I think, gives us our best remaining tiles if we're trying to bingo, but here, since we have the C, it's not going to be super easy. I can, yeah, what I played was flood. Where is flood in this list? It's not. yeah, I think giving up the L hurts my chances later. I did see I had clef here, Just I well, there is a spot for Clef. It just doesn't score anything, but probably that's a decent play. I just didn't like the double O. So it's a I can forgive myself a bit for this. Yeah. Although, yeah, having an open R in this lane is dangerous, especially when they're already off to a lead. So, yeah, how many ways could I have blocked this? Fog would have blocked it. Forgo would have blocked it. Yeah, there's not a whole ton of ways to block it, so either I see fog or I don't. So I missed it. What did I play here? Was this where I phonied? Oh, this is cool. I mean, this doesn't improve my chances of bingoing at all, but it does prevent a third bingo from going down in a row. Yeah, sometimes if your opponent's played some really heavy tiles or has played a dump of vowels or a dump of consonants, you can start to get concerned that they're going to bingo again next turn. So, but that's not necessary here because they bingo twice in a row. Wow, this is not easy. So this underscores the importance of me just knowing my C words. Because if I don't, well, I have a C and an A. It's just there aren't any CA words here. So other than cagule. All right, well, that can happen. So how did all this happen? This happened because this is a decent start. I dumped the X. Yeah, so my problems compounded when I got rid of my E. And I need to be dumping more consonants and end up. Yeah, Flood did no favors for me. Exchanging could have been better than playing Flood. Because, yeah. During the game, my opponent was concerned that I was building up for Cooley. I don't. That's Cooli, right? The food. But I never had the eye to try to do that. So we have Ugyu, we have Gyu. Gyu, Gan, Ug, and E. Oh, that's interesting, but leaves us with UG afterward. More findable for somebody in my range would be just mean without the trailing E. Gwe? Oh, wait, June? Don't know this. There's a lot of words to know. Oh, Mew. I did see I had that on my rack. I was not familiar with A-N-E. And this is a decent leave, too. So this would have been a reasonable way to continue. It blocks the play, like some word from the H to the double, and suggests that they would continue trying to build up to the y, up from the Y here. Or I could take this spot if I knew words that ended that way. Yeah, so studying, reviewing all the twos and threes and then learning some 2 to 3 and 3 to 4 words could be useful, even if that's not what made the difference here. So we played mean. He played Dewey. I'm curious with this, like there's a lot of possibilities, right? Oh, all right, Dewey there, And there, yeah, I was surprised to see this side of the board taken when, just, I don't know. Veer two, that's dangerous because I could have an E. Yeah, that's not good. The analyzer will suggest things by based on equity. So yeah, this is playable. Other words, score better and open the board, but that opening the board's dangerous here. That's cute. Oh, that's exchange six was a reasonable play. Yeah, later on in the series I did exchange sometimes. But when exchange six is your third best play, leaving you with, I mean, an E is a decent leave. It just says that I've misplayed this, and this is a good time to exchange if I don't see a good dump. That's a really good dump, though. That would have been nice. This would have been decent. This is actually super risky and not worth doing, so it's either you see this or maybe you see Luge. Luge would have been good. I saw Fugue. I did not find anywhere to put Fugue. Eggy Vug with a second G. This could be a nice one to know. That's dangerous because the opponent could have ING or, well, really that's the main thing that ends in G. Exchange all is one of the top plays. And then you have plays that are worse than exchanging all. We did one of those worst plays and we burned up our E. Why did I do this? How much time did I spend on this move? 25 seconds to play something that's worse than exchanging all the tiles. Yeah. In general, that just shows how much I am against exchanging tiles, that even in this situation, I wouldn't do it, even though it's pretty clear. I didn't know whether bag is an adjective, in which case it cannot accept an S. Yeah, if there's any situation where it's fine to exchange, it's a situation where neither player is able to play, so this would have been a good time to exchange. What's going on here? Oh, that's beautiful. Wreathing, which is what got played in the game. Yeah. So just imagine that play where we were considering, like, was it UG? This would have gone down through the triple if I'd played UG. So you can't take everything the analyzer suggests literally. Yeah, this would be a good word to know. Bugs, Vuggy, Govs. Okay, so bag does accept an S. Yeah, Vugs and Govs would have been correct. Sug would have been okay. I played none of the above. I played a phony. I'm just in time pressure at this point and not thinking clearly. Okay, I played Govs there. Uvula. Oh, Uvula is cool. Sev. All right. Yeah, so it just shows the. Oh, I did play Govs. All right. I'm trying to improve my rack, but there's not much I can do at this point. And they bingo again, as they should. That's a cool word. Ew. That would have been fantastic. That fits several places with several spellings. So, wait. My. Oh, I see. There's we there, and then there's wet over here. And all these letters here except an E before them. That's cool. What else? E new? Ween. There's a word. Even if you're not super, if you're not going to find ew with the W at the end all the time. Well, that's acceptable in the North American word list also, isn't it? But yeah, this would have been nice. Yeah, we burn. Oh, I see what was happening. I was so allergic to having this G and this U still here from having GU, the previous hand, that I overreacted and needed to dump it. And yeah, now I have a different problem. So I need to adapt to circumstances. And I did not do that. Oh, coolie accepts a Y. Oh, we could have done Y or I or oi. Yes. Yes, raise not a word. Opponent exchanged. We just start dropping letters. We did find dits. Is dits best? It's not. Tray? How? Well, on equity. Oh, well. Okay, I see. Yeah. OD makes some sense. What's left in the bag here? Yeah. I don't even think the analyzer considers that the fact that there are the T's left in the bag, but. And there's nowhere to put a bingo anyway. But putting a D here in column 8 is risky, but we're already down hundreds of points, so this is the time to take risks. That said, my rack is terrible. So, yeah, they block. I mean, they're going to block this every time, and they do. Wow, lots of words here. Linty, nastily, or Natalie, litany. Yeah, both of us missed a bunch of Y words. Or they didn't have a lot of Y words this game. I missed a lot of Y words. They missed a few here. So one thing I'm missing, I'm missing whether or not, like, I don't have a way in this interface to check easily if that's a word. I'd need to install a program to do that. Granted, I'm playing against a master, so clearly, under normal conditions, they would play perfectly good words. Ricky's nice. Ricky. Riki. Wow, that's cool. Nookie, Roki. If I just study words ending in certain letters, that could help. Ko and Oba. After the game, I saw that. That was too late. Eco over here is playable. What did I do? Yeah, I played a phony. So, just panicked the whole time and eventually I think I lost on time. Or no, we did complete the game. And they finally took the Y. So nicely done. Yeah, so just shows some early decisions and my tendency to play the E when I get it. Tends to get me in trouble, so I gotta know more words. I gotta find more words. Cool here is interesting because it blocks them from immediately using the triple unless they draw a Y or an S. Eventually they do take it, but since I'm already down, I needed to do something crazy. So that was game one. We'll see how many of these games. I don't know if I need to go thoroughly through every game, pointing out everything I missed. Eek is playable. So. All these very. Oh, of course. Yeah, I considered both eeks And then I played a different word. I played keen. I was not sure if keens was a word. Knees is definitely a word. I wouldn't put the N there. Yeah, I'd be more amenable to this sort of play. But yeah, keeping the N would have better balanced this. Need to keep that balance in mind. Now it just happens that they could play this, and okay, what can I do? Kids is fine. What did I play? I played kid, keeping the S. I had two S's, so my opponent doesn't have an S. It's not always true, but yeah, undoubling the S makes sense if I'm trying to bingo, and I should be trying to bingo. I was a bit rattled from the first game and concerned that my opponent is more likely to bingo than I am, especially after dumping two consonants and one of them being a high scoring letter. The fact they haven't played something longer suggests that they're in a decent position or in a terrible position, and we'll know which on the next turn. So, yeah, this is actually not a great position. Yeah, so then they exchange four when they see that I'm not doing anything exciting. So ids and jets would have been a good scoring play. And it would offer some interesting hook possibilities. I have to study 3-4 conversion. But yeah, that would be great. Especially if we know that keen accepts an S, they can't block both spaces. And this is a decent leave. So yeah, they exchange. Where is exchange in my. Oh, just kidding. Okay, well, I'm not going to find all of these. Double I words are worth knowing. Are there other words here? I don't even know what this means. I've never heard of it before. Ids is still playable. Lees is good. Delis. And Jeet. Yeah, that makes sense. INS is a good leave. Part of this might be figuring out which letters do I want to keep, which ones do I want to burn. With what I had in my rack, it was not so obvious. To me, anyway, like how do you divide this up? I mean, dens looks okay, leaving me with LIS. Oh, and another I. Yeah, I considered dens and then thought, well, I wanted to play dins and then saw though I can't play jet I. So yeah, I'm better at finding super common words than dealing with this. But that's another reason to know my four, so I could play ids and then build either atop or below. Yeah. Oh, this is decent. So while they just exchanged, I have no idea what they have in their rack. But since they exchanged four, it's unlikely they'll have a bingo. So they play this to try to close the board. What do we have here? Snifted. That's cool. And that plays both above and below. Find and fend would have been good. The other find is okay, but does not leave the greatest leave ever. Fiend again. So, my play was find. Okay. Yeah, that's decent. If I'm not gonna find Snifted, maybe I will someday, but maybe not yesterday. This is a decent way to play. Problem is, I'm Actually, I'm ahead on score at the moment. But if I continue missing bingos, my opponent's eventually going to find one. And there we are. Is this the only bingo they have? Oh, Rosarian. Nice. Huh. Wait, so their previous play dumped TIRRS. Because I think they previously had, two S's, three R's. That's just not the most enjoyable thing. So this is a good word, TIRR, for me to know. If I end up in a similar spot, unlikely, but it's good to know. Yeah. Ori nasal. All right, wait. So against this, because this alternates vowel and consonant, I just have difficulty finding parallel plays. Because I have to find a word that alternates consonant vowel to play across it. Whereas if there's a word where it's just a couple vowels, a couple consonants, etc., I can stagger my letters to try to match. So what are all my parallel? Oh my goodness. There's one. Bi-state, baddies, bi-state, baddies, Batiste. And then we have some eights. Yeah. I think if hypothetically were my in my opponent's spot and I saw bi-state go down, I would think that that very likely were valid. This perhaps given a lot of time, I could have found this. And Blitz, not so much. But with the duplicated T and the B, I was not expecting. Even though I've got like four consonants, three vowels, this is perfect. But that is said, bait, or that aside, bait is decent. Beat, bit. So, what did I select? I selected bat. This has its own merit too. Prevents another bingo from going down immediately, but I should take the corner. I missed both beats here. No, I had one beat. Is that the only word I had to take the corner? Bait? Oh, nice. Yeah, so that would have been great. This is something I should have played. Okay, and from here, what should I do? Well, I might not find that, to put it mildly. That's. Oh. Okay. Well, I'm embarrassed. No. Really? Huh. I pronounced that in my head. I thought surely that's not a word, and I did not know Keynes either. Okay, whatever. Yeah, there's just a zillion bingos here. With two I's and a U, but a blank makes a lot of things possible. Blanks are hard to. Well, am I confusing myself? I don't know. Yeah, so I thought I needed to dump an I to find a bingo. And these would have been fun, but that's never happening. Unities. Okay. So I need to recognize a common suffix, IES, IER, although I don't have an R here. Utilize. Yeah. All right. Whatever. So yeah, we dumped an I and the U. Our opponent also dumps an I and a U and other letters. All right, so did I play chi here? I did. Tenebrae is an excellent play. Because I've not throughout the entire game blocked this open N. That would have been cool. That's unlikely for me to find. Div and Yid. Wow. Over dies. Not sure why. Other words score better than a bingo here. Wow. The triple really is this powerful. That's nuts. Oh, I'm sorry, this is a bingo. But no, this scores this one here with the Y on a double. And this is a triple word score. This, you never see it open like this, but okay. That's how something played ahead of Seaweed here. What did I select? Evade? No, this is using too many E's. I need to find some common-ish word that elf that doesn't have like a zillion cross or interplays. So this would be something more in the caliber of what I should be looking for. Although, well, it's a decent leave. Oh, that's a good one to know. Although you have to have two E's to play it, and the V and the Y. Wait, if Yid is playable down here, it's playable up there too. Dev is, yeah, that's one of our threes, but again, I'd be looking to play something up here. So, yeah, Yin and Yes or Dev or something up here. Die. Dye, yeah. It scores best down here, but die is playable at the top of the board. If I want to try to leave a lane open in case I might be able to use it with my remaining tiles. Instead, I block and I'm just. Yep. Okay, so here I played Lynx. That's cool. Yeah, finding things with the bingo is hard. Oh, Onyx. There's a word I should know. Ryokan. That's nice. Oryx? So Onyx and Oryx are both words. And then you have. Wow. Lots of interesting words in this game. Baryons. Carrions. Crayons. There's a common word. Eventually, I found cray, which might not have been valid. I think it is. I think it's a fish. But crayons, definitely in my vocabulary. But finding things with the blank can be challenging if you're not iterating through every possibility. So, yeah, I was concerned that they were going to use the triple one way or the other. But they can't possibly have good plays every single play of the game. I can only be so paranoid. I think grow is fine, right? Topo? Huh. Hmm. That's cool. That would have been really nice. That said, if this has a good leave, then surely putting OW over here would have an equally good leave. This just scores through a double letter twice. So yeah, knowing your twos and threes can be very powerful. That way you're not burning up E's and R's and other nice letters every single turn. Yep, so we have fairies. Okay, well, yeah, there's really no excuse for me missing all of these. I'm already over time, but I should know at least one of these. So fairies with an E here, but you could spell the other. Well, no, you have two E's. Yeah, knowing words that have two E's could be useful, but also I have a tendency to burn my E very quickly. So, utility of knowing just one word list, and that's a big word list, it's not super high. Tunico is a great play. Yeah, that's not acceptable, but I have to find something. Mew, me, and ma'am. Scam? Yeah. Sif. Sif is cool. But yeah, Moz. There's one I could have found. I could find ma'am, it's just not easy. Anyway, so yeah, the common thing that I've noticed or had a sense of after this series was just that I was missing twos, threes, fours, and the occasional bingo, but the bingos I'm missing all involve the blank. And that's a difficult skill to master. It's much easier to master the twos, threes, and fours and not be burning the letters that help me most with scoring common bingos. Yeah, Binate is cool. What else is there, I wonder? Benny, Bannett. All right. Foci. I was just impressed that I found Foci. Falconer. Lawrence, Florence, Conifer. That's beautiful. There's a seven. Don't need to study eights to get the sevens. Yeah. Flock. That's kind of cool because it leaves this REN. Yeah, so studying more fours would help me with this opening salvo stuff. Fern. After the game, it occurred to me that I had Fern. That was too late. Now we're just getting too witty and leaving a C behind that's going to be difficult to use later. So foci is decent in terms of it doesn't score well. But what I'm left with after it, oh, I have n just one vowel. So I'm gambling on getting decent letters. N flower. That's beautiful. Lu, new, renew, rue. Yeah. So just pick something that gives me a good leave. So the focus here is just give me a decent leave when I'm done. I burned my E. Really, the Z's not going anywhere. There's places to score everywhere here. So yeah, Rue, New, Lou. Why Lou? RONE is decent. Yeah. RONE, I guess, is a better leave than other leaves here. Not saying that I'm always going to find Lou here, but I could find FE, I could find OW and EW and probably stick a letter before that. So I could construct things backwards like that and find it. But yeah, by burning my best letters and all my vowels, I end up in trouble. Especially as the board starts to seal. NOH, yeah, that's a word I need to play more. Hen is good. Yeah, like these leaves get worse and worse as I keep playing off all my E's. I played hen over here. Yep, this closes this part of the board. So now we gotta find something down through the B. What might we even. I don't know. Oh my gosh. Wait, did I find this game? I think I did. Yes, I did. Wow, there's. Yeah, with the ing suffix, it's easy to find stuff. So, for once, I did not panic in this match, but found a bingo. One of the two highest scoring bingos here. Just because they go through the double word score. There's not any other. I mean, most of these. Let's see, if I'm looking at this side, it's only this one over here that can be doubled. So, yeah. Glancer. Angleek. Huh. Yeah, relacing would have been good too. Would encourage a play through the eye, which would open up other stuff. Yeah, so clearing shuts down part of the board. I am up 2 points, but closing the board is probably not good until I have a very comfortable lead, which is unlikely. Yeah, closing the board is gonna hurt me in most circumstances because I will burn lots of time thinking about plays. Did I play Waxy here if I remember right? Windy, Waxy. Yeah, I played Waxy. Just need to get rid of these high scoring tiles since just make it a little easier for me to find how to play my remaining letters. Yeah, that was decent. Is there better? Quad. Oh, that is nice. I was so impressed that I found Kadi that I did not look for this. I had time. Should have spent it a little bit. Not sure I could have found it. What else is there? Quare? Qua? So qua and quad are worth knowing. I'm not sure, like the analyzer suggests that INR is a better leave than DINR. And of course it's right. But even among common words, that's probably correct that like an ED suffix is not going to happen just because I have a D. Quay. Now we have no vowels. Yeah, I don't like that so much. But quad would have been excellent. Qua would have been okay. Cade or Cadi was playable. It just doesn't score nearly as much. So I lost 20 points there. Did leave this open, but then so I had two U's, and I was impressed that I found Ulu. How should I think about this? Instead of just immediately enabling the analyzer, we've got urine that burns the E. Got lure that goes to the corner. Burns the E. I think, yeah, maybe I don't need to look carefully through all these games. I think the first games that I played, the first five, were my best five. And just went downhill after those five. So, yeah, I don't know enough words. It's the conclusion. And the words I've got to know, if I'm playing at this level, involve a lot of four-letter words. Ruru. That's a nice stump. Guru, I know this one. Rerun. And Virge. All right. Oh, that would be beautiful. I think ultimately, didn't my opponent play through this at some point? Even in Blitz? Ruin? Yeah, ruin here. That's something I could find. Leave me with Rue afterward. Yeah, so my problem after playing Ulu, well, my consonant vowel balance is okay. But yeah, they have chance after chance after chance at playing a bingo if I'm not going to block things. Like, I didn't block thens. And evidently I didn't block the A and the G here. So, yeah, they drew decently. I drew decently. Yeah. I could have countered back. Could have made it back. Nervier, I've seen before. I had time to try to find this, but seems a bit challenging. Yeah, even Nerve here would have been hard to find. I was focused on trying to score down either the S or the L. And I'm just not seeing any way with these letters that could get a word that hits either triple. So when they're considering bingos, they're considering not only what scores them well, but what might also challenge the opponent in finding some reply. And sometimes that'll make a difference. Yes, I played live or live. And what did I miss here? There's not an eight. Okay. Not that I would have found it, but yeah, I guess the duplication of the E, well, that doesn't help, or it doesn't change anything. We're starting with an E. There might be some crazy eights in some circumstances if I don't duplicate my R. But yeah, I just have to find words at this point. There's just have to play out and accept that I'm not taking this. Realm was decent. How did Realm score among all these? Writ? I mean, yeah, stuff that scores through Wizen was excellent. Vire. Yeah, I keep getting paranoid that only my opponent has chances to bingo. Such, like, they could play clear rings, they could play thens, they could play anything down the front. There's no way I can stop all the bingos. So, trying to block a lane is not my best use of time. Just, even though, see, so yeah, Lar here was the play. Rin would have been the play also. These are things I needed to be looking for. Assuming I'm not going to find the more spectacular stuff. Giddies is very nice. Care point place cut. Oh, it went over here. All right, what did we miss this time? Bed drops. That's interesting. Boats. Boats. Knob. Knob is nice. Knob is something I could find. Yep, and pie is playable. Yeah, I just. Yeah, this is not the correct place to put that. I mean, at the very least, I could, like, try. Well, poet doesn't score any better. Yes, I'm sorry. Poets, if I knew this. So knowing more forests would help me. Yeah, if I'm gonna try to block bingos, I should at least stick to the theme. Yeah, and here I just start panicking, and it doesn't affect the game outcome much. Sorer. Knowing how to play out could be useful. Homers? S'more? Sore? Roots. That's cool. Yeah, so how many did we get through? This was game three, right? Yeah, perhaps rather than further beating myself up about missing twos, threes, fours, and extensions, we just accept that I played decently well for an amateur player. I was outclassed. I did find a bingo. I can be somewhat happy of that. I did not manage my time correctly. So here I played Caddy instead of Quad or Qua. So yeah, my sense of like if I'm gonna try to block all the bingo lanes, actually commit to it. Don't just half commit to it. Our opponent did very well finding the words involving the blanks, but they were burning faster through letters than I was, or faster through tiles, so there's not a whole lot I could do. But yeah, spending a little time early could help me out a lot more later on, so need to learn and be familiar with words that don't heavily rely on E. But yeah, it was a series of exciting games. Throughout some of the games, well, in some of them I just completely missed that my opponent was threatening to bingo. Some of them I did see, well, he just played some heavy tiles, or he just played only a few tiles, and it looks like he's getting ready. And eventually I started trying to block in those situations, and I ran out my time several times, just searching for decent scoring plays that also clog the board and make my task more challenging. So yeah, thanks very much to Evans Clinchy, our tournament organizer, going by the name of Vinyl Chances, for running this event. And I'll look forward to playing future rounds. It's not every day that tournament directors open a tournament so just anyone can play in it. So we'll make the most of this, learn as much as we can. As much as we say about the meta here, we actually have to put in the hard work of studying some words and playing more games. It's not something that just comes overnight. But it's interesting to see. Just by playing the games, we can see what we are seeing, what we're missing. And we're missing a lot, but we can get better at that.